I'm starting a paracord project this afternoon. It's hot outside, too hot to get out and do anything, so. I got this blank from Paracord Galaxy, and I'm going to wrap this handle. And I was thinking dark camo, but I'm kind of leaning towards this desert camo. I'm going to do it with that, I think. But I'm doing the West Country Whipping Wrap on it, which is on Paracord Galaxy's website. I'm going to try to do this without a tripod. I'm using a measuring cup for a tripod. You need at least 10 feet of paracord. I'm doing 12 so I have some extra. You can use this for any knife handle, hiking stick, whatever. I'm going to try to do it so you can, everyone can see it. Don't know if this is going to work or not. But I'm going to put the tip back on the knife, that's for sure. There. Okay. So you want to fold your paracord in half. Get it so it's under this. Get this straight here. Okay, you want about at least 10 feet of cord, whatever your choice. It's going to be a little hard to work with because it's really long right now, but put the right side over, then I got a hair in there or something. Okay, then the left side over the right, as you can see. And then this bottom, this cord here, bring it up under, tuck it under there, pull it through. And then push all that up close to the top and tighten it. So it should look like that. Very tight. Okay. Then flip over your knife. Take me a minute to flip this over. Then do the same thing again. The right side over, like that. Left side over, like that. Make sure you keep that pushed up and tight. And then you got it like this. Take this one that's on the right, push it up under this one and pull it through. So, and then tighten it. Tighten it real tight and try to keep it pushed up too. Okay, then flip it over again. You keep doing the same thing, but on the opposite side. Just keep flipping it. So the right over, left over that. I need to break down, get a tripod. But, so that's crossed over that. Then this one goes tucked up under that. So this goes up under this one. Pull it through. And, again, push it up so it's up snug next to the other one. And tighten it. Just be careful your hand don't slip. Like, I'm a klutz, so I'll probably end up cutting myself and end up cutting yourself on this upper part. So that's that so far. Then you flip it again. Right over it. That's kind of awkward because there's so much cord here. So much paracord. I'm using 550 paracord, by the way. Okay, then the left over the right, and then the left comes up under under the right one. You basically keep doing that all the way through. You can do this with a hiking stick, whatever. Make sure it's real tight. Ugh. That's what it looks like so far. I just thought the camo colors were kind of blah, the greens. I wanted to go with something different. So this is desert camo, and I got this at Paracord Galaxy. So that's that one. Then we flip it over again. Right over the top. Left over that. And I'm trying not to knock my camera over while I'm doing this too. Okay, so right is over, then the left is over the right. And then bring the left one up under the right one. Tighten it. What it's starting to look like so far. Pretty cool. I'm going to finish doing this, and you just keep flipping it over. Make sure you keep flipping each time so you get both sides, and I'll show it to you when I get towards the end. I'm halfway into it already, so, and it looks really cool. I'm glad I picked that color. This is what it looks like. This is desert camo. And again, it's from Paracord Galaxy. You know, it's a while since I bought it, so I don't know if they carry that still. But I'm sure they carry something equivalent if they don't have that. But that's really cool looking. I'm going to have to figure out some type of sheath to make for this also. But turned out pretty cool. Getting almost done. Now when you get down to where you want, you put both ends through the hole, flip it over, and do an overhand knot on the other side. And then just cut off the excess, or you can tie, you know, leave like maybe 6 inches of the paracord and tie a diamond knot or other decorative knot. So I'll show you that when I get it all done. But it's pretty easy. You just got to really make sure you keep pushing this up and make sure it's extremely tight. All right. When you get to the point where you're happy with how much you've got on this handle, then you stop and run these two sides down through the hole in the handle. You can do it with any knife where you can take the outer part of the handles off, and then you can do this over the metal part of the knife. You know, I bought this one this way though. But anyhow, when you're done and you're happy with where you're done at, bring those two pieces through and tie it in an overhand knot and leave however much of a tail you want. You can leave a wrist strap and put diamond knots like that. I've decided I don't want that on this knife. I've got it on several other knives. So I'm just going to tie it overhead. Or overhand, sorry. I'm just going to tie an overhand knot in mine. And overhand knot is just where you take it like this, like a loop, and bring this part back through this loop and pull it tight. And then cut off the excess. And there is the knot after I pulled it. You want to pull it really tight. And I should say that since this was open, I've seen a few other videos where they take duct tape and wrap the bottom of the blade on both sides, cover the whole bottom with duct tape, and they wear gloves. So you may want to take those precautions when you do this. You know me though, I'm crazy. I'm always cutting myself, so I didn't want to worry about it, but I was just really careful. And most of this, you're working, you know, away from that blade. So the only time when I was pulling this, I thought if your hand slipped, you might hit that, though. So you might want to cover it with duct tape. But that's it. And then I'm going to cut it, I don't know, probably about right here. I haven't decided yet if I want to have a wrist strap or not. So I'm going to think about it for a little bit. But you can cut it real short, you know, like right there. And just have those hang. Any ends that you have when you decide where you want them, get a lighter, like a Bic lighter, melt the ends, and then take a flathead screwdriver, and while it's still a little bit warm, press down like that with the screwdriver, and it'll flatten that out. But I'm not sure what I want to do with this yet, so. But you want to always melt your ends. That'll keep it from fraying more. So, anyhow, that's my knife. I'm very happy with how it turned out. And again, this is the Desert Camo from Paracord Galaxy. And the knife is from there, too. I think this was the 4-inch blade. And it's a blade on one side. They also have a dagger on their website, which has the blade on both of these sides. But I didn't want that. Just look at their website. They've got several options. And I think they were about $9 or $10, something like that, which isn't bad. It's got a real nice weight to it, too. For camping, I figure it's good, you know. And I'm going to try to make a sheath. If I do anything with that, I'll maybe make a video also. So, I had, it calls for 10 feet of paracord. And I had 12 feet, so, and I really don't have a heck of a lot left. I mean, there's that much left, which isn't, you know, a whole lot. Especially if you maybe want a wrist strap. And by the time you tie a knot, 12 feet would be perfect. So, allow plenty so that, depending on your knife, too. If you got a knife this is only a 4-inch blade. But, so if you've got a bigger knife, bigger handle, or maybe twice that length. Here's where it's at on my hand. I don't know how many inches this is, but kind of figure accordingly because you're going to need more. But I really like how this wrap feels too. It's very, very nice. Very happy.